Good morning. Today we are going to review the secret of drilling an oil well. In this example, we will simplify the process by considering a case of land rig and a simple oil well with three casings. Without further delay, let the site preparation team move in. As the name suggests, their duty are to prepare the site before the rig arrives. They level up the location, make a concrete pad so that the rigs and heavy equipment can sit on, fence the location, move in the accommodation camp, and many more. Before they leave the location, they dig a conductor cell and put a conductor pipe in. The cell is usually about 1.5 to 3 meters deep, depending on location and well types to be drilled. The conductor is usually 36 inches and 3 to 4 meters long. It provides guidance for the first section to be drilled by the rig, as we will see later. Then the rig comes to drill the first section, which we call surface section. We have to firstly drill this section deeper than water bearing formation with fresh water so that formation will not be contaminated with any chemical. Secondly, we have to end this section at the shell. This is to ensure casing shoe intricacy, because shell is a very dense and compact formation. Then we put the first casing, which we call surface casing. After that, we cement it with formation. This way, water-bearing formation is protected throughout the rest of drilling process. You may observe that we drill this section without any protection. There are reasons for that. Firstly, and obviously, there is no platform or anything to sit blowout preventer or BOP on. Secondly, it is not necessary. There is not much pressure in this section because we drill very shallow just to cover water-bearing formation. Now we have surface casing cemented firmly with formation, so we can mount BOP on it. With BOP in place, we can drill further. We call intermediate section. For the same reason, we end the section in the last shell, because before entering reservoir, this shell is usually served as a cap rock. As the name implies, it provides a seal on top of reservoir so that the petroleum doesn't migrate up to surface. Then we put the second casing in the hole and cement it. We call it intermediate casing. The last section is production section because we are going to produce hydrocarbon from this section. We repeat the same process. The drilling down to cover the reservoir, but not too deep to enter the water below, or we may produce water instead. Before we put the casing in the hole, we usually run wireline locking because we want to know petrophysic properties of the reservoir rock so that we can optimize the completion and production method later, or at least we have to know top and bottom of the hydrocarbon section. We may do one or more locking runs depending on how much we would like to know. Then we put the last casing in the hole, which we call production casing, and cement it. The drilling phase is completed here. The next process we call completion, meaning necessary ways or techniques to have hydrocarbon delivered to surface. Before drilling delivers the well to completion, we have to change fluid from drilling mud to completion fluid, which is usually wetted brine, because mud contains solid particles, mainly barite and bentonite. Completion equipment does not like solid particles. Now we have a well ready to take hydrocarbon in. The only one problem is that we have casing metal and cement between hydrocarbon in the formation and the well. What we have to do is to make a flow path by puncturing the casing and cement. To achieve this, we use shaped charged explosive carried by white line down in the well. This shaped charged explosive is the same as what military used to shoot tanks. Now we have flow path, but we have to do a few steps before we reduce pressure in the well to allow hydrocarbon come into the well. Firstly, we install a piece of rubber ring inside production casing as deep as possible, but above the top of perforation. We call this rubber piece a packer. Secondly, we put a tubing string inside it. We call this tubing production tubing. Now we can move the rig out and bring a set of surface valves in. We call it Christmas tree. Look like everything is in place for hydrocarbon to come in. The last bit is to reduce weight of completion fluid in the well so that it is less than formation pressure to allow hydrocarbon to flow into the well. Technically, we call the process unloading the well. There are several techniques to unload the well, but we will not explain here. Let's say that we can unload it. Then the hydrocarbon will flow in like this. That is it. Briefly, how we drill and produce oil. Thanks for watching this clip till the end. If you want to see more of these easily learning clips, please click subscribe and follow us. Bye for now.